next interview is of Dr. Raysix of Stillwater, Oklahoma. He lives at 101 South Lowry. He had an early assignment in China as a missionary. Spell his name, R-A-Y-S-I-X.
Oh.
About 400 pounds a minute, and
What if imagine here the Chinese gentleman, Dr. Maxson, sat directly opposite him and I sat over here. And over we passed the history and tried to forth. And Dr. Maxson asked me on the moon and he reached over his teacup with his finger and wrote the character upside down to himself as facing Dr. Maxson. And Dr. Max recognized the character, and then he elucidated on that, just started to philosophically and so on. And then the old gentleman asked Dr. Macklin his name. And Dr. Macklin did likewise. He said, oh, he's saying that is my dishonorable name. He did, and he put his finger in his own teacup and wrote his character upside down to himself as facing him. And in the Chinese character, you bring the, when you come down this way with it, and then cross in down here, and then there are four little bath ducks to go in here. And the old gentleman smiled and said, oh, I see, it's a two ways of riding it. If you're in a hurry, you'll place to make all four ducks, you just put one.
Uh-huh.
Well, this means horse,
horse
mall. And he said, he lived this real fast here, and said, oh, he said, I see a one-legged horse. And then he asked me my honorable name, and I told him that, what it was, and then I was going to try down also.
Uh-huh.
And made comments on that and said to
Six. What is your doctorate in? Philosophy?
Geology.
Geology.
I have six earned degrees.
Raysix, what are they?
Well, I've got regular AD, and I have master's in Greek.
Greek?
Mm-hmm. And I have a master's in biblical history. Honestly, I don't ever think of it very often. I'm AD and an MS.
Geology.
And then I have several other things that are more important to me than those. And I have one in linguistics and one more. The idea is 12 languages other than English.
You can speak them fluently?
I don't anymore. I read them pretty well. I don't remember if I was an Indian guy who taught us as far as I could speak. They're far more expressive. And then I continued reading those things. I still divide the mind and just read.
In Greek? Well, in Hebrew, they have a real intricate alphabet, don't they?
No, it's not bad. It's not a bad language.
Oh, it's not?
English is a more complex language than I've ever had anything to do
with. Is that right?
English is not. Doesn't picture an idea.
Just says it.
And in Chinese, you don't conjugate and decline.
Uh-huh.
Minus all of that. But they have variation of tone. So, and they have, I have one document that I got it from Yu Bo Shan, that my Lotus Flower Mountain down in Southern Way. Where there are used to be something of a 200 big monastery that was communist. Communists have planned out all of them.
Communists? What year was that in?
Oh, that was about 27.
The communists were doing that then?
Yeah, they just struck the country and everything that that's okay for. I bought some hot hat when I went there. Missionary relieved me to my education responsibilities to travel with old Dr. Mackin and Dr. C.T. Paul, who was the head of Mission University in Indianapolis.
Mm-hmm.
And he'd been out there 18 years before and had just about died of smallpox. He had pissed all over his body like that. My other man over there, by the way. And so he came out to finish up the group on Dr. Mackin asked that I be relieved of my education responsibilities to go with him. So I picked air travel things of that sort, take pictures, and I made a seat there with architecture drawings of monastery. And in Yu Bo Shan, they had several hundred monasteries there, and we did lived in two or three of the larger ones, and they had great print shops, and characters about this big, carved in reverse, and the document I have was printed from movable block type, handmade, and ink was handmade, and the paper was handmade.
Do you have one of those?
No. And this was printed in 625 AD. There's an interesting book in my library over here that I just returned yesterday on the history of the invention of printing in northeast China and the edge of Korea. Its development, it took it 2,000 years to get over to Europe.
Yes.
And in Gutenberg, got around to move the block type and everything. I forgot my finger tag. But they had everything of that sort.
You have that document right here at your house?
Yes, I have. And they, so, well, in that area there, when a monk died, or abbot died, he was dehydrated and was encased in gold leaf. And he put on a seat, and then he was encased in glass. And they had 40 or 50 living Buddhists, the term applied to them, because they were personified that way.
Well, are they still that way there now?
No, the communists burned out that way. Pakistan, there are marvelous libraries and history of the human thought, everything of that sort. Then the down at Pupo Cham, that's an island off the east coast. There were two great monasteries there and four or five small ones. The great northern monastery, it had a marvelous library, better than our college library by far.
And the communists got it?
They didn't get all of that. But this one up there, their idea was to destroy everything. That's the opposite to their concept. And we visited with, lived in the monastery. One other thing about this area there, and then on out of Omicron, Western and Sichuan. We had hot and cold running water in the apartment where we lived, a sewer system. And we had drinking water that was separate from that. And they were put in there before our ancestors thought of having that. Cut that off on the back of it. That experience was critical. Nothing or anything else in my life. Here is something came up here. What's the Boomer Lake? You see, concretion.
Mm-hmm.
Well, back in Permian time, that's why I cracked the tube, and there's the outline of a ferret, or whatever you want to call it. See, that was a mud ball originally. And then when it dried out, it had those cracks inside. And then groundwater filled it with calcite.
Well, have you ever seen one formed like a person like this before?
The other half of that is in the Cook University Museum.
Well, were you born right here in Stillwater, Dr. Six?
Northern West Virginia.
Northern West Virginia? So you've been all over the world, all over the United States.
Well, I haven't been in Maine and I haven't been in Oregon. I've been in all the other states. I've flown over. And I took that out of circulation in China.
1776, it's still in circulation, you were there?
Yes, one time, the Nanhui, they ran short on coinage. And so they imported a lot of them, several tens of thousands of them from the Philippines. And They covered about 40 years. I used to have a complete setup when I gotten rid of all of them except that. I had my wife and my children and my silver daughter. I took that out of circulation.
That's a solid tiller, isn't it?
You can see where money changers dug a little bit out. I eventually had them.
Is that what those are?
Yeah. Those are removed, some of them. Might be able to gain a little bit of them.
But they did a whole bunch, well, then they...
Yeah, they...
I'll be... Well, tell me about when the bandits got you.
Now, here it comes on. That one is 50 BC, and this is 150 BC. And those were taken out of circulation and set on.
50 BC? I don't think I've ever held anything at all before. What kind of, is this just metal?
There's copper. Bad hit corroder. It goes out of circulation. Please take a box. Normally it takes about as many as 400 of those that people want to use.
400? I taught here at school for 32 years.
More likely
this, you said this was made in like 1400? You know, I had no idea that they can make things like this in 1400.
In the old engineering library, I've never located it in the new library, but the combined library, the book on watches. It's fascinating. It's fascinating and more so than the first monkey war catalog you ever saw.
Bank in the safe deposit box. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I sure appreciate you talking to me.
Back home coldly. Missionary over here in Lake Forest, North Carolina. He and his older son are still doing work in the southwestern part of the United States, north of Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Well, one of his books recently is on Roman Jewish colonies in Arizona, New Mexico, and West Texas. And those were established by the Romans in the 6th and 7th centuries.
In Arizona?
And he's still excavating every summer on that area. And up here on the north, where Boomer Lake is, that platform is out there. All around 1,800, 2,000 feet north of there, we first came here. I found an ancient campsite there, and I sent some of the charcoal to research base in Chicago, the type of the state. 2800 BC, plus or minus a few years.
How could you tell that was a campsite?
Well, if you're acquainted with those things, you can tell where somebody built one.
Yeah.
Well, this one got covered up. And other things around there, some bones. And then, are you acquainted with the work that Dr. Powell of Harvard University is doing in the whole thing? He is one of the few people who has been able to work out the language and translate the ancient inscriptions that are way before scriptures you and I know it. In North Africa, across Europe, in New England, for instance, in New Hampshire, the Celts were in there, and the inscriptions were made by the Celts came across there. I forgot the date of the song. Somebody else in those five levels I brought that was Colonel Minster. Lives out here in Paris from the airport now. And he was stationed in Turkey for a long time. But, for instance, the ancient Celtic priest came across from France to England in a coracle. You know those round boats that they spread skin over framework made with flexible bushes and so on.
Mm-hmm.
And paddling across the English Channel and that.
Mm-hmm.
And then they also see in Brittany, in southwest England, in Wales, western Scotland, and Ireland, those were settled by the Celts way back before anybody else. And they also sailed across the North Atlantic and founded colonies in New England and way on down the coast. And the people ancient Carthaginians, or before that, they were sailing back and forth across the Atlantic. And ancient Egypt, one of their pharaohs way, way back about, well, they didn't call them pharaohs, and then I forgot what their title was, but they they sailed everywhere, I guess. One of them outfitted a fleet of seagoing ships, built them on the Nile, and then they went through the five different channels, canal from the Nile through to the Red Sea. And then they went out down into the Indian Ocean, around the northern part of the Indian Ocean, up the Euphrates and Tigris and the Indus and the Ganges, around through past the Malay Peninsula, up the east coast of Asia. They went up the Yangtze and the Yellow and others, and went clear back up to the bed as far as they could go. And then they came back out, they went north around the upper Pacific, and down the west coast of this country, and out in the Bay Area of California, they put down land markers showing that it was now possessed by their ruler back in Egypt. Down in the Bay Area of California, things up there, and then down around the west coast of Chile, around Santiago, they took possession of 400 miles of coastline, clear back to the crest of the Andes. And then they went around the Horn, up the east coast of South America, exploring those things. I have seen reproductions of maps that they made. And then up the east coast of South America, and up the Orinoco, and the Rio de la Plata, and the Amazon, and others, and then around Central America, up, and they came up the Red River, they came up the Arkansas, or the Cimarron here, clear on up to northwestern Oklahoma, out in the far end of Cimarron County. You can't get in there now except by special permission. There are caves that have beautiful paintings on the ceiling that were made by those boys.
In Cimarron County?
Mm-hmm. Old Uncle Billy Baker, and I was doing some work with the Alaska Survey out there, took me out and showed me them.
Out in
north of Kenton.
Okay, out in the Black Mesa?
Yeah, that country there and others. Southeast of there is another beautiful area. And the thing that Dr. Willis Stovall of the University of Oklahoma, who was in charge of their museum, he'd worked out there a lot. And Uncle Billy Baker had showed them to him, and also to the previous director of the director who would give us the survey here. And, one of the museums in Colorado, they were down in that area, and Uncle Billy Baker showed what he had been doing out there and showed them other caves. And so he took them and showed them what he'd been doing, showed them other caves that had not been touched. And when they came back out to Highway 64, they went northwest toward Kenton. If they're going back home, Uncle Billy Baker came back to Boyd City, which is a county seat out there.
Yeah.
When he got over the horizon, they came back in, went into the cave he'd been working, drilled 2.5-inch hole there, put in dynamite, messed it all up. Not a lot of nice stuff, but totally non-valuable for their purpose. And Stovall got the state legislature to pass a very strict law. You have to get permission to go in there, and you have to be trained to do it accurately and right. And there has to be an observer along with you.
So there's still pictures out there.
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen them?
I've seen a lot of them. I haven't seen all of them anyway. Why do you think they're going into a fine gallery except everything's on the roof or on the ceiling? And then they went on around and came up all the drainage lines of the Mississippi Valley, now up the East Coast, up to Labrador, and then they sailed from there to the Iberian Peninsula, Spain. They'd already explored the North Atlantic. And then they went to the place of going back through the Mediterranean home, they went all the way around Africa doing the same thing, going for several years. Most of our history, I only know one or two histories that you didn't mention. The record is very detailed. I'd take some of these boys that like to divide, tell them about that, and go down here and cross the river from Perkins and up the river there in the Horse Beach Canyon area. They'd pass out and wake up on those canyons. They'd almost imagine they saw some of those things coming along the river. Worked out grammar, all that kind of thing that he mentioned in scripture. And he just thrilled to death.
Yeah.
Perfect.
You know,
Harvard, they have, if I never met him, I corresponded with him right here. And well, Harvard, anybody who's there is very well financed. And one of the responsibilities of the graduate fellowship is there is when you become able to contribute something to their research fund. Mm-hmm. They do, or me, or somebody else. And no matter how far it may seem out to the average person, things are well used. And he has been able to actually decipher the languages. Some of them, of these ancient people, you ever notice the Christian church over here, the inscription that's in the east side of the tower?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm quite sure now after watching that, the artist, I don't think, knew very much about it. That sort of thing. But I sent that to Dr. Powell, and he's sure that that is a poor representation of an ancient language.
And they, it was put there merely for architecture,
art over there.
Yeah.
He had seen a lot of things like that, and so he made that. It seems to go right, but also it walked across the history of the earth and don't know much about it. I mean, they did not even discover a photograph.
You like milk? Sugar in your body.
Oh no, thank you.
Straight?
Yeah, that's fine. Gosh, thank you.
All of this.
You told him when you moved, didn't you? That's when everything's all torn up there.
Well, you told me you're fixing to go out there. Y'all are gonna.
Just taking our curtains down and pack our books and all sorts of stuff. Waiting for a daughter to come. And she's gonna be with us a week to help us. We're gonna have a yard sale or a porch sale or something. And we'll take the meat out with us.
Where is it to say you're gonna move to in New Mexico?
Las Cruces.
Las Cruces?
I was worked out through that country in 1913.
You know, I have a friend that's moving out there in 2 weeks to Las Cruces, New Mexico. He's moving out there. I guess the town's really growing.
Yeah.
He's moving out there to open up a...
You made a map. Well, he took the map the government had, and then he walked. He walked the trail through and his wife was driving around meeting over there. It was a unique thing. Well, she was born in Barnet, Kansas, on one of the big stops on the Santa Fe Trail in northern.
Yeah. Yeah, she came and talked to my class. Yeah.
Well, she's the one that started the map collection over there, cataloging and so on.
Here?
Mm-hmm. Over on our little corner. And the former head of the geography here, I helped her get her started on that.
She sure was an interesting lady.
Yes, she. I remember in college algebra class, she was as shy as the rest of us.
Oh, no, ma'am. Thank you. She was what?
Shy as some of the rest of us. College professor was some sort of a deity sitting on a dais or something like that, you know. But the teacher we had was a marvel. He knew how these things came into being in history. Not only in the normal historical sequences, but whatever.
Dr. Six, I'm going to have to go.